We all know about grinding. Most games have some kind of grind associated with them. And in some games, that's actually really, really good. In a lot of cases, it is actually very rewarding to spend the time deeply immersing yourself in the various mechanics of the game to A, get better, and B, get better things. But when is a grind artificial? And when does gaming stop benefiting from it? Hi folks, it's Falcon. And today on Gameranx, we're going to discuss how artificial grinding is changing games. It's become the norm in video games to have a lot of things to unlock. And that means cosmetics, as much as it means gameplay mechanics. We talked in videos about how single-player games used to have a lot of things that you got by cheating, now as unlockables. Basically, anything that has a big head mode does it that way now instead of puts it behind a cheat. But more importantly, so much of what you do in a multiplayer game now is unlocked through playing the game for a set amount of time, accruing some kind of points, and yes, there is a way to sidestep the artificial grind, and yes, it does rhyme with microtransactions. Actions, but we're not actually going to talk about that this video. Yes, it is related. Yes, a lot of the artificial grind is attempting to feed you into that, but it's not just that, and we want to talk about the other stuff. So grinding isn't bad. Frankly, there are grinds that are designed well. It doesn't feel like a tedious, horrific process, and instead feels like an actual progression. You feel as though you're eased into certain weapons or powers, and it can be used to effectively teach a player how to play the game, as well as give the player input about the style of play that they're going to be playing. Here's the small issue with that, though. It really has to be carefully done, because the majority of people who play multiplayer games are not people playing their first multiplayer game. And here's where we start to encounter the problem of artificial grinding. What in a grind is artificial really depends on how skilled you are. But what we can safely call an artificial grind is stuff that the average player, who's played for some time but is maybe not a professional, could very easily utilize without being eased into it. Because in my opinion, the useful aspect of progression is ensuring the player is always comfortable with the choices they're presented with. But what happens when there's a common language where most of the things that you're talking about here become tedious? Why not just have tutorials? Optional tutorials. I'm not saying there shouldn't be any grinding whatsoever, because there does need to be some kind of barrier for entry. If everybody could just come in and ravage the place, they probably would, and I'd assert there's probably not going to be the same kind of community building going on. Part of what builds a community is mutual struggle, and when the real struggle is basically just between skill levels, there's nothing that really bonds a player who is learning to a player who already knows. Progression can help with that, and I'm not here to just demonize it. But what about Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, where they literally lock classes of players, or to use Infinite Warfare speak, rigs, types of mechanized bodysuits that you can occupy during a multiplayer match? And I'm sure somebody could make the case that it works to ease players into the different classes, but what if you just like, this is the class that I've used in other games, or is similar to, and I want to do that? Or what if you just want to learn one of those classes? It seems to me if you're properly balancing matchmaking, you want players of the same skill level occupying all the different classes, which would mean in a properly balanced match you wouldn't have those kinds of classes, which makes the early matches much more boring, speaking hypothetically at least. Frankly, if you properly design the classes, the best version of the match is the match with all of them, meaning you basically have to play a bunch of boring matches before you even see a player in a different class. And that's assuming they properly balance it. If they improperly balance it, then those matches are just entirely unfair and unfun for that reason. And while a lot of people are very competitive, ultimately you're not playing for money, you're playing to have fun. The vast majority of players are here for fun. So why do these kinds of grinds? Well, the more games that have it, the more you feel as though you have to invest your time into that type of a game. And the more investment you make, the more hard it is to start spending time in other games. I put in all this work here. I've progressed to this point here. Why would I want to move over there? And that is an entirely rational viewpoint for a player to have, because the economy created by having these types of grinds is one of time. Games including these types of artificial grinds are basically forcing you to pledge your fealty to that game, because your time is valuable. You put that work in and you got those rewards back. You have progressed here. Time is a limited resource, and you've invested time into this game and into its virtual world. And in that world, you have more of what is designated as attainable through investment. Now let's talk about positive progression. Overwatch is a good example of how progression can be used correctly. And yes, there are unlockables in Overwatch, but they're all cosmetic and they don't really figure into what we're talking about. Overwatch has a competitive ladder. You progress in rank, which is essentially just how much you've played and how good you've played. It's an accumulative total that essentially only functions as teams are created for matches. It also works as a little bit of e-peen for certain people. This function works specifically just to feel as though you've gone deeper in Overwatch. That's pretty much it. It's not telling you you can't actually play the full game with all of its functions until you've played it for 20 hours or so, in some cases more. It's like, hey, we've got a fun game. You're welcome to get better at it, get deeper in, and as you've done more, we'll recognize you've done more. That's pretty much it, which is nice. But like I said, not every single progression model is bad. You don't have to use the Overwatch, there's literally no progression that affects gameplay model for it to be all right. But with the classes and balancing example I gave, it should be fairly obvious exactly how detrimental it can be. It can just make a game dull, and in the case of bad balancing, can make it impossible. Either way, it's not fun, and artificial grinding is ultimately getting in the way of having fun. And thing is, I can remember a time where there wasn't this type of stuff, and I still felt really attached to the games that I liked, and I played those games more than my other games. It seems like these attempts to kind of force loyalty could be used to glaze over the fact that a game isn't as good as it could have been, which sucks. What's the worst artificial grind you've ever had to do? It can be a single-player game, but the vast majority of this stuff happens in multiplayer games, so leave a comment. If you enjoyed this video, please click like. And if you're not subscribed, now would be a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every day of the week, and the best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription. As always, we thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter @FalconTheHero, and we'll see you next time right here on Gameranx.